I'm Cornelia Featherstone. I live at Findhorn in the northeast of Scotland, and this is the garden in my house. I've lived here for the last 30 plus years, and I have a phenomenal joy of playing and eating from this garden over the years. Well, the soil here in the garden is actually sand. This was part of sand dunes, and you can see that only 400 meters further north, you know, it's just rolling sand dunes into the North Sea. So this garden was sand and still is sand. I have to feed it regularly, and if I go down even a foot in the low beds, you know, there will still be sand again, no matter how much organic matter I put on top. Nonetheless, it's a very productive and bountiful organic garden. Miraculous, as you know, the Findhorn Gardens got famous for growing big vegetables on sandy soil. There were then some theories, you know, that there are more minerals in the sandy soil, that that was possible. I don't do 40 pound cabbages, but I do have a very, very productive and beautiful garden. Growing my own food for me is ultimate abundance. It's true wealth. For me to be able to go out here, harvest something and eat it within 10-15 minutes, that's true luxury. I can't explain it any other than that. For me, it's wealth, it's richness. It's a joy to eat what needs to be eaten in the garden. I don't need to think about recipes and stuff. I just eat what needs to be eaten in the garden. So right now I will eat a lot of green leafy things because they can't be preserved very easily. Later on in the year, I will eat more kale and winter lettucey things, and start eating things that I have frozen from the garden. So I have, in the years when I'm on top of it, I can eat 52 weeks a year from the garden. And because I have a polytunnel, I can even harvest a little bit for 52 weeks of the year. I got a physical condition that I couldn't bend down as sustained as I did before in the garden, and that was a source of sadness for me. And then I just one day had the idea, I want to garden at hip height. I want to just walk around and just do this. But we got pallets, and they're just the right height, and we stuck them together and we filled them up. And we now have several raised beds at hip height, and one is even a bit higher. And it's so much easier for me to do that, and I can play in the garden much more without having a sore back at the end, and also somehow in shorter stints, and it doesn't matter. I don't know why that should be different on the ground compared to the raised bed, but it is. In the raised bed, I see a difference in half an hour, and if I have a sore back, I can just rest. Yeah. I love my raised beds, and my initial raised beds worked really well. It's the one over there, and it's quite big, and I was oblivious to the reason why that one worked. And what it is, it's two very long pallets from builders, one 2.5 meters and one 4 meters. And then I stuck single pallets onto that and made a U-shaped raised bed, and it worked. So I thought, oh, that's easy. So the next raised bed I made in straight lines, and it didn't work. It bowed, and one of them even split. So what I've now learned is what you have to do is to take four single pallets and make a pillar. And you can put several pillars next to each other if you want a longer bed, but to brace the pallets, to avoid the soil pushing outwards, each one needs to stand on its own. The other thing I've learned, initially I filled them with brush, which is fine, it fills up quickly, but the next year you're down by more than a foot. So the next ones I've just filled up with topsoil. Topsoil is quite cheap to get. They even are happy to deliver it to you because they come from building sites and things like that. And then the top foot and a half, I put in good soil. And also at the moment, I have come across a wonderful source for household sterilized council compost, yeah, which is relatively cheap to get and is wonderful for top layer of mulching because, as you can see here, very little weeds grow on it, at least in the first season, which is great fun because it makes gardening even easier. Yeah.
So initially we did practice double digging
because we had to dig in a lot of organic matter, and there are also tree roots. So in the low beds, even now, I will have to do some digging, but in my raised beds, I practice completely no dig. I just layer on top every year. And I have to say that that's a much easier and much more joyful way of gardening. It's great for my back, but it also feels so much more easeful with the soil itself. The soil feels happier, if that makes any sense.
Well, if you're starting out and you don't want to invest in a huge amount of implements and stuff, start small. Yeah, start with a 4-pallet raised bed with the topsoil that you find in your area, and build up garden compost. Your own food compost. And within a year or two, you have organic matter that will keep feeding your beds. Now I found the source of the local council compost, which is very, very cheap, that allows me to feed the ground as it feeds me. Yeah. And it doesn't have to cost the world. Gardens are a wonderful access to food. Food other than packaged stuff in the supermarket, and particularly for children, that can be very important. My own son didn't like vegetables, but if he could come in the garden and pick the peas, he would eat them. If he could come and pick the courgette, he would eat it. And that is because they're a direct link with his experience, and that was really wonderful to see. I mean, the undercover growing spaces, I have a glass house and a polytunnel, a small polytunnel. They have extended my season dramatically, and they allow me to do seeds early on in the season, but then also do things like tomatoes, which I wouldn't be able to grow outside here in the northeast of Scotland. They also allow me to grow 52 weeks a year, some things to come out, even if it's only herbs, but it also is kale, it is chard, it is some winter lettuce that will not survive outside, but I can go in the polytunnel and harvest a little handful for a meal to just stay in touch with the garden eating throughout the year. So that has really changed how I, which crops I can grow. My polytunnel is actually not very sunny, but it still grows courgettes and French beans, which I wouldn't be able to grow outside in this microclimate. Okay, so my personal gardening style is quite haphazard. But generally, I am a very intuitive gardener, so I need to be out in the garden. I need to water myself in order to notice what's needed. So I need to be here in order to pick up what the next steps are and what else I need to do. But somehow the garden still gets along.